12th साइंस चैप्टर 10 हेलो एल्केन्स एंड हेलो एरीन्स पार्ट 2 मेथड्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन ऑफ हेलो एल्केन्स फर्स्ट पार्ट।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मधुसिना, योर केमिस्ट्री टीचर। वॉच माय यूट्यूब वीडियोस, लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब इट फॉर फर्दर नोटिफिकेशन। In this video, we will discuss about the methods of preparation of haloalkanes. Haloalkanes can be prepared by a number of methods. Let us discuss one by one. The first method of preparation of haloalkanes is from alcohols. Alcohols are easily accessible and we can readily prepare haloalkanes from alcohols. A number of different processes can be used for preparing haloalkanes from alcohol. ROH is the general formula of alcohol when it is treated with HX. HX stands for hydrogen halide, where X is chlorine, bromine or iodine. We are not taking fluorine because fluoro compounds, they are prepared by different methods. In presence of ZnCl2 as a catalyst, collectively HX and ZnCl2 is known as Lucas reagent. So the bond will break from here. The OH gets substituted by halogen to give you RX plus H2O. For example, we can prepare ethyl chloride from ethanol, or I can convert ethanol to chloroethane. CH3CH2OH is the formula of ethanol. When I treat it with HCl in presence of ZnCl2 as a catalyst, the bond from here breaks, chlorine substitutes OH to give you CH3CH2Cl and water is liberated. So this is how we can apply the concept for conversion purpose. Let us see the another method of preparation. Next method is specifically applicable for the formation of bromo compounds. ROH plus NaBr in presence of H2SO4 gives RBr plus NaHSO4 plus H2O. Let us see another method, ROH plus PX3. We are treating it with phosphorus trihalide, where X is either chlorine or bromine. So it forms RX plus H3PO3. Balance the reaction. So by this method, we can prepare only chloro and bromo compounds and not iodo compounds. ROH on treating with PCl5. Specifically, you are preparing chloro compounds using this method from alcohol. ROH plus PCl5 gives RCl plus POCl3. POCl3 stands for phosphorus oxychloride plus HCl. One more method is there for preparation of chloro compounds, ROH plus SOCl2. It stands for thionyl chloride. Gives RCl plus SO2 gas plus HCl. Normally it is said that preparation of chloro compounds using thionyl chloride from alcohol is the best method for preparation. The reason is that both the byproducts which are evolved in the reaction, they both are gases and they readily move away in the atmosphere, leaving behind your pure product. In rest of the methods, you can see we are having mixture of products, and then after preparation you have to carry out purification. But here we don't require that specific method of purification, because both the gases, they are liberated out in the atmosphere, leaving behind pure chloro compounds. So that is why this is the best method for preparing chloro compounds. Apart from this, we are having one more method, ROH. When treated with red phosphorus in presence of halogen, where X here stands for Br and I. That means using this method, you can prepare only bromo compounds and iodo compound. If I say X2, X2 will stand for Br2 or I2. Okay, so when you are treating it with the halogen in presence of red phosphorus, you get RX. So these are the different methods of preparing haloalkanes from alcohol. If we talk about the order of reactivity of alcohol towards the formation of these haloalkanes, so order of reactivity of alcohol. Of alcohol is 3 degree greater than 2 degree is greater than 1 degree. That means 3 degree alcohols, they are most reactive towards the formation of haloalkanes. Now this method from alcohol, we can put a note of this, not applicable for preparation of aryl halides. What is the reason that this method is not applicable for the preparation of aryl halides? The reason is that because the carbon oxygen bond in phenol, we are talking the starting product will be, starting reactant will be phenol. The carbon oxygen bond in phenol has partial double bond character. So it is difficult to break. Right? If I draw a benzene ring having three alternate double bonds, here is the carbon, oxygen and hydrogen is bonded here. The oxygen out here is having lone pair. So the lone pair, this resonance stabilized benzene ring goes to form a double bond here, and the bond breaks to form a lone pair here. So if I put, we are having something like this. This bond and this bond is as usual. The bond breaks and forms a lone pair here. And carbon is here. You get a double bond OH. Now since oxygen is deficient of lone pair, it assumes it bears a positive charge. Now you can see this is carbon oxygen double bond. And this bond is comparatively difficult to break. Let us go for the next method of preparation of haloalkanes, and that is from hydrocarbons. In this, the first method is free radical halogenation. Free radicals, whenever you treat the halogen with UV light, it gets broken into the atoms. For example, I am taking Cl2 and I am treating it in presence of UV light. So this chlorine-chlorine bond breaks to form chlorine atom, and this is called as nascent chlorine or free radical, and they are very reactive species. So free radical chlorination and bromination
takes place in presence of
UV light to give a mixture of isomeric polychloroalkanes or polybromoalkanes. So instead of that, I will write polyhaloalkanes, which are difficult to separate. So even if you prepare it, you will not be able to separate it, right? As pure compounds, difficult to separate as pure compounds. Take an example. I'm taking CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, and I am treating it with chlorine in presence of UV light. So you can see this chlorine is able to replace all these hydrogens and tear hydrogen. This is a chain reaction. So once the chain reaction starts, it is not going to stop in between. It will keep on continuing till there is a single replaceable hydrogen left. So that we may get a mixture of product. For example, first time anywhere it gets, right, plus CH3, CH2, CHCl, CH3, and so on. This is going to continue unlimited till a single replaceable hydrogen is left. So this method is normally not used.